Welcome to IgnitED Research. With this IgnitED-inspired video series, we aim to build stronger connections between learning science and instructional practice. In this installment, we talk to educator Cindy Green about coherent ways to build and activate prior knowledge to maximize learning. All new content and skill knowledge mentally connects to existing information in our brains. Centuries of research have shown that appropriately activating prior knowledge improves both recall and interest, or in other words, learning. In fact, prior knowledge, or understanding, building, or activating a student's prerequisite content and skill experiences to ensure deep learning, is one factor that has been shown through different theoretical perspectives to be a critical factor in long-term, lasting, and accurate learning. Learners benefit most from instructional experiences that build coherently and directly upon relevant cultural, content, and skill knowledge they already have. Educators play critical roles in understanding the prerequisite knowledge learners have and in supplying or activating prior knowledge in their learning. Cindy Green, high school English and AP literature instructor at Virtual Arkansas, shared with us some of the activities she uses to identify and activate her students' prior cultural, content, and skill knowledge. How do you build on students' prior experience and cultural knowledge when teaching a new skill, like critical text analysis?
When I first start teaching them to analyze, you know, they think, well, I don't know how to do that, or they're unfamiliar with, let's say, poetry. So I bring something from their real life. So I use music. That's how I start. I did a week long at the Teachers Institute at the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame several years ago. And so I've started using music in that way. And I wanted them to start analyzing a song first, because if it comes to argument or defending their idea of evidence in the song, they're much more likely to do that and feel more confident about it than they do with a piece of literature. They don't realize that they've been looking at some version of that when they hear lyrics from their favorite songs or artists. So we start there. And then I always tell them, even at the beginning of the year, you may hate me or love me for this, but you're going to be doing this for the rest of your life.
So Cindy, you teach in a virtual setting and use online meeting software like Zoom to activate your students' prior knowledge through pre-questioning, guided inquiry, and guided practice by combining all of these in a strategy called Socratic Seminar, right? Could you describe to us how that works in a virtual space?
So in Socratic Seminar, the inner circle is the actively talking group. Then your outer circle is listening or taking notes. My students have already prepared questions and answered their questions. That's another thing. Students have a hard time coming up with multi-level and layered questions and knowledge questions. So I provide them at the beginning and they start to create them toward the end of the year. So the ones that are inner circle, their cameras are on. Everyone else will turn their cameras off. So then you know who your active speakers are. Everybody with a camera off is now in the chat. So they can talk to each other, but not disturb the inner circle in the chat. I always put a student in charge of outer circle and a student in charge of inner circle to help me. I also require my students to speak so many times. That also holds them accountable to participate. So that helps your quiet students. It kind of gets them to participate, and it helps your students overly talk to limit, because they know once they hit their limit, they're going to be moved to the outer circle and someone else is going to come in. Once somebody in the inner circle has met their minimum, I move them to the outer and I put someone else in. And I do all that in chat so it never disturbs the conversation. And so then it just rolls that way.
All learners come with existing content, skill, and cultural knowledge. Educators can maximize student learning by understanding, building upon, and leveraging these components within the learning experience. As researcher David Ossebel said, the most important single factor influencing learning is what the learner already knows. Ascertain this and teach him accordingly. Blended or personalized practices in a classroom can build or activate prerequisite knowledge in a cohesive and engaging way. Teachers can be aware of their students' backgrounds, invite them to relate or describe their relevant knowledge, and be explicit about what is being taught and how it relates to different examples and contexts, including previously learned culturally relevant ones. Students can recall and apply prior knowledge in different contexts, for example, through asking questions, within problem-based learning, or when analyzing text. Technology can be used to link new ideas back to familiar ones, for example, through graphic organizers, provide opportunities for review and practice, and to supply background knowledge to each learner as needed. Thanks for watching, and look out for additional IgnitED Research videos coming soon. You can find more free resources like this one at the Learning Accelerator,